G'day everyone, welcome to Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm Darkmyre and this is LSPDFR Australia Emergency Edition. So basically today we're going to be patrolling in an ambulance, doing a paramedic patrol. I was originally going to be doing this on Monday or Tuesday. Fortunately it's a bit delayed. Basically over the weekend had some issues getting my new CPU cooler installed. That took much longer than anticipated, which kind of set me behind schedule. And once I got that sorted, I had a look at the rescue mod V, the current mod that lets you play as a paramedic or a firefighter. Don't want to say too much bad about it because, you know, it was a well-built mod. There wasn't any bugs or issues or crashes or anything like that. I just personally didn't find it very enjoyable or very fun and didn't think it was something that I could really do a patrol with. So I've instead spent the last couple of days working on adding paramedic as an agency for agency callouts. So that means we will actually be playing through the regular LSPDFR system, getting callouts across the radio like we would normally, only they're going to be paramedic callouts. So I have taken out all of my other callout packs for this patrol, just basically so we're not being called out to shootouts and terrorist activity and God only knows what else. Within agency callouts, we'll only get the paramedic friendly callouts, although we will still get the homicide investigation one. The plan is for eventually that to be upgraded so the paramedics can do that as a complete callout, but that's not completed yet, so I won't be taking that if it comes over the radio today. But we do have, you know, MVAs, some medical emergencies, patient transports, that kind of thing. Obviously, I've only been working on this for a couple of days, so it still needs quite a bit of polish and depth added to it. But I figured we'll see how we go. It's because we do have a few people that have been asking for an ambulance patrol, so yeah. See how it turns out and see if it can become a regular feature on the channel. So I'll just make sure we are available.
Yep.
So, we're in this, I think it's a Mercedes Sprinter with a Ambulance Service New South Wales skin. Unfortunately, the model itself has a few issues. Not sure why I'm waiting since it's turned right any time on red. The license plate is a static license plate. It's not hooked into the GTA license plate system. And also, if we just turn our lights on for a moment, we can see, even though the light bar is red and blue, we only have blue LEDs lighting up, which is kind of stupid. But, once I can find a better model, I'll definitely update that, but at the moment that's all we can use. And we are also just using the default, looks like the windows are tinted, you can't actually see my character, but yeah, we're just using the default paramedic skin. There's no Australian paramedic skins yet. And because there's no paramedic stuff at all for the emergency uniforms pack, we don't have a partner with us because that pack, the partner uses the EUP clothing. And it would look kind of stupid having a police officer coming along with a paramedic. So let's see if we can get a call and I can show you what the agency callouts paramedic features are all about. Maybe if I can get a call to come.
Attention Unit 1, Ocean 12. Citizens report a DUI on a...
Okay, I'm not sure why that call-out's coming up. That'll probably be the traffic police DUI call-out. So I did forget to disable traffic police's call-outs. And obviously we will also still get the default LSPDFR callouts, which I think is a GTA and armed suspect or armed pursuit or something like that. We'll just have to ignore those like we did that one.
Units reporting a 148 on Alter Street. Gunshots reported. All units respond code 99.
So if we don't get one shortly, we'll use agency callouts as duty menu to request a specific callout. Basically have two callouts available to us, but they do have a bit of variety so far built into them, and by the time this gets released, I'll have a whole heap more. Don't have any idea yet when this will end up being released, but it will definitely be released as it's part of Agency Callouts, so you will sometime in the next few weeks be able to finally play as a paramedic on duty without some third party mod, as well as LSPDFR. Because I also find the less mods you can have running to achieve the same result, like the higher frames you're going to get, the more stable a game you're going to have. It just runs a lot better with less things clogging up the memory there. And, so far we're not getting much come over the radio.
Dispatch to all South Los Santos units. We have a medical emergency in Strawberry.
Medical emergency. We don't get many details yet. I will be planning on adding some flavor text details and possibly some different scene situations as well over the next week or two. So basically we have to roll up on scene and we may just need to transport a injured civilian back to the hospital. We may actually have someone unconscious that we'll need to attempt to revive. I'm kind of hoping for that, because then I can get to show you my awesome new CPR, I guess it's kind of, would be considered a minigame. It does actually take a bit of skill. It's not just a case of tapping a button for a little bit and then rolling a random number generator to see if the patient survives or not. If you, if you can get the timing right, you can basically revive them every time. If you get it wrong, well, you're going to end up with some dead bodies. So yeah, we have someone unconscious near the ATM and phones. May have possibly been a robbery gone wrong. Now one thing with this, these animations for the CPR stuff, it's very, very fucking fiddly to try and line up. So I haven't bothered making the actual unconscious body move with the animation. It should be possible, but I haven't set that up yet. And it's often out of time, so I just need to pay attention. So as you can see, we need to hit T to do the compressions as the compression bar is near the top. If we mistime it, we actually basically injure the person a little bit more and their pulse drops. We need to fill that pulse meter to resuscitate them. And there we go. We have this lady revived. She will now wander off and apparently go back to using the ATM. So there you go. Maybe she had a heart attack or something. I know you normally wouldn't let someone that's been unconscious just wander off like that. That's another sort of realism aspect they'll be fixing up in the coming days and weeks. Yeah, we'll get back out on patrol and see if there are any other civilians that need our assistance today. I should turn my lights on because it's starting to get a bit dark as evening approaches. Hey, fucking give way, mate. Not like you can't see me in this big ass ambulance.
Units reporting a criminal resisting arrest.
So yeah, that's one of the ones that we can't take. Which is a bit annoying.
All units respond, code 99. Any available unit in the South Los Santos area? We have a civilian in need of assistance in Chamberlain Hills.
Now, I did make the ambulance be able to take this call. I'm not sure if I'll leave that in or not.
Ocean 12. Respond code 2.
Not sure it's entirely realistic for a paramedic to attend to a welfare check type situation. If you have any thoughts on that, feel free to drop a comment below and I'll be able to take that into account to make this paramedic extension as awesome as possible for you guys. Also, if you have any other ideas of things that the paramedics could do on their duties, we'd love to hear from them to expand this out as much as possible. I'm not sure at the moment. I don't really have any plans to do a firefighter type expansion. There is another firefighter mod out there, and I haven't tried Rescue V's firefighter functions yet. So yeah, I most likely won't, unless both of those mods are horrible. Bother messing around with firefighting stuff. I think it's already been done. So I am also considering doing a Coast Guard pack for agency callouts to add some water-based callouts as well. Yeah, not sure yet. So let's see what's going on with this guy. See if he needs medical assistance today.
I'm gonna kick your ass!
Okay, not sure why he's wanting to fight us. Thankfully, because it is LSPDFR, we do still get our standard gear. So, step away. You will be tased and detained. I know this may not seem entirely realistic. I'm pretty sure, though, the New South Wales Ambulance Service do have the right to detain civilians, basically if they're causing a threat to their own or other people's safety.
Watch where you're going.
So yeah, he's basically just detained at the moment. We'll hand him over to the police and they can deal with him as they see fit. Oops, not what I meant to do. Meant to turn around to come out here to the ambulance. Fuck, get off the stairs. So, too drunk to drive and decided to try and fight us. Well, we'll let the PD take care of that. We don't have time for that kind of shit. We're out here trying to friggin' save lives and bring people back to life and all that fun stuff. And this fat idiot just wants to get drunk and beat up paramedics.
Waste of space.
Just end that. Apparently it already was ended. It's always good. And yeah, so we'll be back on patrol. Well, it's not really patrol as much as just kind of being mobile, ready to respond if there's an emergency near us. It's interesting looking for the audio files for these type of calls. You find all sorts of really weird things that Rockstar have put in the game. Like, there is actually dispatch audio that they've paid someone, like a voice actor, to record for weird things like a Ebola outbreak.
Unit in the South Los Santos area. We've got an ambulance call in Chamberlain Hills.
You often hear people saying that Rockstar's anti-modding, that there's so much content within the game that isn't used. It almost seems perfectly designed for LSPDFR type mods. And I don't think you can really say they're against modding. It's almost like they've spent resources for modders, which is kind of cool. Okay, so this one we have a patient with a serious medical condition that we need to transport to the hospital for some treatment. And this one adds another little challenge to the thing. To things, basically, you need to drive carefully. Every single bump, every car I hit, every light post, anything like that, it's going to make the patient lose health. And obviously they lose all their health, they die. And the last thing a paramedic wants is a patient to die in the back of their ambulance. Not sure why she's running off. Hopefully she'll still get in the ambulance. We have a friggin' shootout erupting behind us. Let's just friggin' get the fuck out of here really quickly. I mean, we do have guns, but we really shouldn't be using them. I feel wrong as it is having used that taser just before. So let's just GTFO from there. And get this patient around to the hospital as quickly as we can.
Hey, watch it! Jesus Christ!
So once they get there, this paramedic will help them. They will just kind of walk off, sometimes across the road. I've got to fix those spawn points for the animations a bit better. But as I said, it is still an early work in progress, just kind of giving you guys a bit of a preview of what's happening so far, because people have been asking for a paramedic ambulance style patrol.
Dispatch to all South Los Santos units. We have a 187.
You are so lucky I'm in an ambulance today, mate. Let you off, I can drop driving corners right there.
Copy, dispatch. We'll assist.
Dispatch to all South Los Santos units. We've got a civilian shot in Chamberlain Hill.
Well, that's hardly surprising. So at the moment, that's just randomly selecting the type of audio call it's going to give us. The scene is generally not any different. Sometimes if the patient is unconscious, there will also be a police unit on scene. But at the moment, that's just very random and not really connected. As I said a few times now, it is still in development, so we'll get those things tidied up for future patrols and before it gets released. Alright, so here we go, we've a civilian shot, and we have a police officer on scene doing his, well, I guess pretending to do his policing work. He's kind of standing there scratching his chin, not doing much of all. I'll hopefully be getting back into the streaming tomorrow. Not sure if you can tell, but from the sound of my voice, but I have been a bit sick the last couple of days as well, which has made it a bit tricky to get any recording or streaming done. Yeah, assuming I'm feeling better tomorrow, I'll have the stream back up and running, and that'll be from about 10 a.m. Sydney time, so do keep an eye out for that. So again, animations and stuff need a bit more work, it needs more depth added to it, but, you know, it's better than not being able to be a paramedic at all. And yeah, if you are new to the channel, I do try and upload and stream quite regularly, so do hit that subscribe button just to make sure you get notified when I'm going live and when I've got a new patrol up. And you can get your daily fix of Australian GTA content. And I do have a new non-LSPDFR GTA series I'm probably going to start up in the next few days as well. So that should be quite good. And yeah, if you're subscribed, you will see a notification when that gets uploaded. Might actually let the next one go just so you guys can see that yes, it is, you know, it's not totally guaranteed that you will revive them. There is a chance the patient can die, and once they're dead, they're dead. You can't just sit there keeping on trying till you get it right. You get one crack at it, and if they die, they're dead. Not sure what that's all about, but let's drive around them. It is so challenging for this type of patrol to not drive like a maniac or, you know, drive hard when you're trying to get to a call. Because obviously, in an ambulance, I've got to take a lot more care about what sort of harm I cause the civilians of Los Santos. You know, if you're in a high-speed pursuit, you can kind of almost justify, you know, knocking traffic out the way, but when you're in an ambulance and you hit somebody and accidentally kill them, it's not a very good look.
Any available unit in the South Los Santos area? We have an ambulance call in, Davis.
Alright, so we have another transport request.
Ocean 12, respond code 3.
I think this will be a lot more fun once I've got sort of the symptoms or, you know, what's actually wrong with them being generated for bit of added flavour. So again, this is the one where we need to be very careful not to hit anything so that we don't accidentally kill the patient before we get them to hospital. Just ignore the dodging cage in the back of the ambulance. It's obviously not been updated when the model was made into an ambulance, I think. Because I'm guessing that would be either a like a prison transport type model, or maybe a work van, delivery van, that kind of thing. Certainly not, you know, a cage is not something you'd expect to see in the back of an ambulance, that's for sure. So we're coming up here on the Central Los Santos Medical Center. I just have to find the friggin' entry to emergency. Here we go. I think this one, it usually actually looks the most legit, with the patient drop-off at this state hospital.
Hey, what's happening?
At least during testing anyway. Now, of course, yeah. Now, of course, it's going to make them go off into the wall and disappear. But that's okay. We can roleplay that or whatever. At least for the time being.
Dispatch calling Unit 1, Ocean 12. Citizens report, a driver under the influence on Innocence Boulevard. Dispatch to all South Los Santos units. We have an overdose civilian in Strawberry.
Bloody drug overdose in Strawberry as well.
1, Ocean 12. Respond code 3.
So, the worst thing about doing an ambulance patrol ending up south in the South Los Santos area is, you know, most of these injuries are pretty much self-inflicted, either by choice or by lifestyle, which is a bit sad, a bit disappointing, a bit unfortunate and all that sort of thing, but not really much we can do other than try and do the best we can for each of the casualties. So where is this guy gonna be? Is he in the friggin' backyard? Would just be like a backup EMS unit and drive randomly down alleyways and try not to crash into walls, but I'll do it LSPD style and jump over the fence and all that fun stuff, because hey, why not?
Right. Holy shit!
So, UAD victim wants to go to hospital for treatment. Victim. Not really much of a victim when you friggin' take too many drugs and overdose. Only then you're just a fucking idiot. You gonna get in, moron? Hello? Okay, I don't quite know why he's not getting in, and I don't think this is going to work very well. Yeah, I have a feeling this is going to crash as soon as we try and stop off at the hospital, but there's no way we can do anything with him, so that's a bug I'll have to try and fix up tonight, because it's kind of annoying. It's even more annoying that I've been at this for probably the last 3 or 4 hours working on this plugin, and this is the first time that shit has happened. Because, you know, I'm streaming. Nope, now everything's just going to kind of sit here and not do anything. Let's end the call out and see how bad it crashes. Not bad at all. So that's at least a little bit of saving grace there. Let's see. We'll have that hospital route now forever, so we're just going to kind of drive away from this area. Well, let's go at code, because I'm getting impatient. I have a hard enough time following the road rules when I'm playing as a copper. I'm having to bloody not crash into things and drive properly, it's even worse. frame rate's bloody dying in the arse a little bit there. So yeah, let's head up into the sort of central area, and we'll take a couple of calls here, and that'll probably wrap it up for this first ambulance patrol.
Dispatch to any available downtown unit. Citizens report an A&E incident in Pillbox Hill.
So we have a motor vehicle accident. This is the regular MVA call-out from Agency Callouts. It has now been upgraded to support the paramedic role as well, so I think it still needs a bit of work. You have to basically manually end the call-out once you've treated the patients, but as you can see, you can actually respond to it as a paramedic. You don't have to do the policing side of things, and it should still work as a call-out. See what we've got here. Injured or unconscious or dead passengers in the van, and the driver of the Jukes as well. So this is going to be, we're going to have our work cut out for us a little bit here, especially with this vehicle up on top of the other one. So we do unfortunately need to grab them out of the vehicle before we can treat them, but then we can go ahead and commence CPR. And, this animation's gonna look really bad. Really, really bad. And, oh my god. So wrong. Oh, Jesus Christ. I almost want to let this guy die after that. And I'm kind of hoping to be able to get it so the patients will have different rhythms. At the moment it's all a static rhythm that's kind of sort of almost based on proper CPR, at least in theory.
What the fuck, dude?
But yeah, I'm thinking of having it that, you know, some passengers will be easier, some people will be easier to revive than others. I don't think we'll be able to get to him in the back or him under there. I guess we could use the ambulance to actually push the Jukes clear, maybe. And we can at least get the Jukes passenger. Fucking tree out of my face, Jesus. Ow! It's hard driving a big old clunker of an ambulance like this. Especially with fucking trees in your way, Jesus Christ. Push, push, push. There we go. Got him clear. So we should actually be on the other side of those cars. Good sign. This side that they are. And that should kind of force traffic around us so we can work here in peace. Hopefully line things up a little bit better, a little bit less inappropriately. Sounds like somebody else injured nearby, but I can't see them. Because of course this means we'll actually be able to even better deal with those ambient events from GTA Comes Alive, like the cardiac arrest patient. We'll actually be able to treat them and hopefully revive them even, which would be good. And we got this guy revived as well, excellent. So just that one in the back that we can't deal with. I know it's not realistic, but we're going to add that here and let them drive off. Because there's not really much we could do about that guy in the back. And I'm just going to take a quick look around the block and see if we can see a vehicle parked where it perhaps shouldn't be. It did definitely sound like somebody got injured or had a cardiac arrest or something. But we can't see anything or anyone needing assistance. Yeah, when this was released, the MVA call-out will probably have a police officer on scene doing the policing side of the call if you're there as a paramedic.
That shook me up.
This car in front, maybe? No, they're just a dickhead. Okay, that's fine. Turning left from the middle lane. Another one, lucky that I'm not in a friggin' cop car tonight.
Attention all units, we've got a suspect resisting arrest on, Las Lagunas Boulevard.
So we have another patient transport call, another one in Chamberlain Hills.
12, respond code 3.
Trying to friggin' get away from Southside, dammit! I might make this the last one because, unfortunately, in the current state that the callout the paramedic expansion is in, it doesn't add a lot of depth and a lot of content to enjoy. So it's kind of very quickly gets to that very samey feeling that you really want to avoid with callouts. So I think this will pretty much do us for tonight. But do let me know in the comments if you did enjoy this episode, and if you'd like to see more paramedic patrols, and if you have any suggestions for either extra callouts or anything like that for the paramedic. And yeah, it'll probably be towards the end of the month, I would guess, that agency callouts will get updated again. Then again, who knows, I might surprise you and upload that in sort of the next week or so. Do keep an eye out over on lcpdfr.com, and if you're subscribed you'll also get a bit of a heads up because I'll post a proper plug-in spotlight for it, basically when it is released. Yeah, I'm not sure if getting shot by idiots will cause the patient to lose health. Oh shit, that certainly will though. Fucking cross when there's an ambulance coming. I mean, if you're gonna get hit by a car, I guess an ambulance is the best thing to get hit by, but Jesus Christ, watch where you're fucking going. There's that medic from before still stuck there. he'll be there forever now. Poor guy. I swear that's the last guy that, well not the last guy, the guy before that I friggin' transported. But anyway, that is gonna do it for this paramedic patrol. I do hope you guys enjoyed it. So, yeah, and as I said, hopefully I'll be back around 10 a.m. tomorrow. That will be Thursday. I think I've got my days right. Pretty embarrassing if I haven't. Yeah, so Thursday, 10 a.m, we should be back with another LSPDFR Australia Police Patrol. And that that will of course be a live stream, and yeah, not sure what kind of patrol we'll do yet. We'll figure that out tomorrow. But yeah, thanks for watching, hope you have enjoyed it, and I will see you next time. Cheerio!